Hello, Internet. My name is Savvy, and today I'm finally listening to the brand new debut album from one of my favorite artists, Shalu. I've been listening to Shalu's music for the past couple of years. I actually got to see him perform in Tampa before moving back to New York. So he's an artist that is very near and dear to me, and his music always pulls me out of any kind of funk. It just puts me in a really good headspace. So I'm really excited to listen to this album. I have heard some of the singles from it, but honestly, I've been trying to stay away from social media so I don't hear anything until I was ready to record. He has been going live on his Instagram the last couple of weeks, just sharing tracks and things like that. So I've been watching. However, I have turned the volume down completely whenever he was playing a track that I didn't know yet. Let's get into it. This album is called Magical Thinking, and the first track is titled Forget. I really like that he opened the album with something a little more up-tempo, upbeat, lighthearted. Really good intro. I enjoyed it. Next track is one that I have heard before. I actually reacted to it in a previous video. It's called Mutual Love, and it's featuring Zachary Knowles. No relation to Beyonce, sadly. I know this song. I love this song. I'm gonna listen to it again. I've said it before, I'll say it again, I love that track. Next track is called Silhouettes, featuring Vancouver Sleep Clinic. Almost sounds like a Coldplay vibe. Maybe it's just his vocal. Electronic sounds and then like nature sounds coming in. Okay, hang on, because that track was so, it comes from like this bittersweet feeling. The beat is incredible. The production is really amazing, but then lyrically it's letting go of someone, so it's kind of sucks. But what I really like about that is how well it transitions into this next track, which is called Try, which is an interlude. Really beautiful. Ooh. Next track, Lethologica. Okay, guitar. God, I love an acoustic guitar. That's him singing now. I really like his voice. Obviously the strings, the guitar, the beat, I like that it wasn't consistent throughout. It was intermittent based on the vibe of the track. But I also really like that sort of click at the end. It's like ejecting a cassette tape, if anyone actually remembers what that sounds like. Next track is called Technicolor Wave. I miss you. Full electronic. I loved the production on that. Like her voice was beautiful. I actually really enjoyed the songwriting too, but you know when you... Y'all stay safe. You know when you hear a track and that's the kind of track that you hear and it just like reverberates through your body. Highly recommend that one on full volume. Next track is called Make Believe. All alone in the streetlight glow, you fall into your head. It's all that you want, it's all that you need. Take some time to make believe. It's all that you want, it's all that you want. Thank you. Let's Tell You, that was, I mean, it fits really well with the rest of the album. I really enjoyed it. Next track is called Fading. We've actually heard this. This was released as a single. I've been playing it out, but we never change. About this track is it's actually written about the environment. It's literally written about the environment and climate change and how we are abusing the planet that we live in and how it's absolutely fading away if we don't do something about it. Next track is called Endless. Sounds like an intro for The Weeknd. Not anymore. This is the song featuring The Knox. Deep dive to follow life once loops inside the never ending you. Just inside the never ending you. Okay, I enjoyed it. And I could definitely hear like the Shaloo influence, this sort of sound that he uses. But I'm not as into it as I am some of the other tracks on this album. I'm kind of surprised because I know the Knox are someone that he was really excited to work with, and I know that he's very, very proud of this track, and he should be. But I honestly like some of his solo work better. The next track features Daya. This is Older. Well, I guess I'm at the end. Her voice is so pretty. Again. Back to breaking down on benches. And it seems nothing hurts. The broken piano. Thought of everyone, I seem to be the one without. That effect on her voice is so pretty. And they still let the guitar live in the track. It's really, really, really cool. To everyone who wants to say, cool. bass was so heavy that it was literally shaking my plants to the point where you could hear the eucalyptus shaking. Oh, so sick. I really, really like that track. I am someone who really enjoys feeling sad sometimes. So that track definitely puts me on my feels, and I love Daya's voice. It's always, always beautiful. So the next track is called Good Together, and it is with Ash. Nice rain effect to open the track.
We couldn't love from a distance. It took some time, but I realized you and I are better off missing each other's eyes.
Flowers on our first date.
With that songwriting, so good. And seriously, they sounded really, really good together. I'm really happy that he's more comfortable with actually using his own voice in his music now. Oh, they sounded so good together. Okay, final track on the album. This is actually the title track. This is Magical Thinking. That bass is so good. Oh, honey.
It's like a speeding train. There's a glowing light still.
Instrumental outro, to be honest. Well, that's it. That's Magical Thinking. Really, really well done. I enjoyed that a lot. I think I'm definitely gonna listen to it repeatedly. While I'm super bummed that the tour got canceled, I hope everyone is safe. I hope everyone is social distancing and washing their hands as much as possible. Everyone is healthy and everyone's loved ones are healthy as well. If you love music and you like reaction videos like this, you can always give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. If you want to connect with me on social media, I'll have my Twitter and Instagram handles below. I'll see you in the next one.